Firstly, you know, we are in lockdown and we are facing quite some tough times with the COVID-19 pandemic. And, you know, just from what we've been seeing on your social media platforms, you look like you've got it all under control. You know, you've been training, you've been in your backyard and trying out new skills. How have you been managing, you know, just to be training on your own?
Hi, thanks so much for having me. So it's a bit difficult with COVID-19 and everything going on with the lockdown, but I think it's important to just have a positive attitude and make the most of a bad situation. So yeah, I've just been doing as much as I can by myself outside, a lot of gym work and skills training, and yeah, I'm just trying to make the most of a bad situation.
Other than doing the training sessions, what else has been keeping you motivated, you know, just to look forward to the next day?
Well, my motivation is really just to improve every single day, and I don't think that we need to look at lockdown as all doom and gloom. I know it is harder for some people, but just take this as an opportunity where you get time to reflect and look at the things that you need to improve, and yeah, I use that as my motivation.
And you mentioned studying. How is it for you, you know, when it comes to balancing your football and your education?
Well, my academics are really important to me. So I've been making sure that I do a lot of schoolwork and I'm staying up to date and doing a bit extra, so that when the time comes to play football again, I make sure I'm not behind or stressed or anything. So yeah, I've been studying quite hard.
Have you been able, you know, just to keep on top of your studies and making sure that your academics are top class?
I think at times it can be quite challenging because both aspects demand a lot of work, but then again you can't be afraid of working hard, and so I'm continuously working hard, and I'm at a fantastic school, Waterstone College, where the teachers are so helpful and they really understand that football is important to me and they try to help me do the best that I can in both areas.
And also, where did your love for sport come from?
I think it really just came from my family. Both my parents are fantastic athletes, and further down the family tree you can see that too. But I think I just owe it to all the hours spent in the garden playing with my mom and dad, you know, kicking a soccer ball outside or throwing a tennis ball, something like that. And I just learned to love every moment of it.
Were there certain soccer players that you saw that actually inspired you to take that route and see it as a career for yourself?
So growing up, yeah, I watched a lot of Premier League when I was little and I always enjoyed that. But it wasn't really a player that inspired me and grew my passion. It was just the feeling that I got every time I walked onto a football pitch or just kicked a soccer ball.
And please tell us more about your journey, you know, how you got into the national team setup and also how you got into JVW girls football team.
In 2015, I attended a trial and I was really happy to hear that I got into JVW. And then in 2017, I went for national team trials, and after many, many camps, I got told that I had made the cut. But like they say, selection is never permanent and you have to keep proving yourself every year to get in.
That is so true. But you have done a tremendous job, you know, in the field. And every year, as you said, that you need to prove yourself, and you've been able to do that. What has been, you know, just your biggest motivation to make sure that every time you step on the pitch, you give the best performance that you have gave the previous game?
Thank you so much. Like I said, my motivation is really just to be better than I was the day before. I just want to be the best that I possibly can be for the team that I'm playing for. And I want to do my country proud, and I really just want them to know that South Africa is not a walkover country and it's somebody that can be reckoned with in the future.
And for all your hard work, you were actually given the captain's armband for the under-17s. What has that journey been like for you, you know, just to lead a national team? That is, because that could be a big responsibility.
Yeah, and it's an honor and privilege that I definitely don't take lightly, but the feeling is nothing short of incredible. Being able to captain your team on the field and lead them to a victory is nothing short of amazing. I just hope that I can make my country proud and make my family proud, even though is a big responsibility.
We must say that you have actually led by example. You've done a great job and we must commend you for that. But also, you've been surrounded by the likes of Simpiwe Dlulu and Janine van Wyk, who actually captains the senior women's team. How have they played a part, you know, in just guiding you along the way?
Thank you so much. I've had such great role models to look up to. Coach Shorty has really helped me just grow and develop as a player in the national team. You know, she's been my coach since 2017 and here we are in 2020. And both Janine and Coach Shorty have captained Banyana Banyana, and they've given me such great guidance and helped me to be a better captain for my team, and I'm really so grateful for that.
And we'll just go back to 2018, because that was also quite a big year for you when you went to the FIFA Under 17 Women's World Cup. Can you just explain to us, you know, just that experience of getting to travel and just play on a global stage?
You know, I don't think I can really describe the experience, but the best word that I can think of is magical. Being able to walk out onto the field wearing your nation's colours and singing the national anthem, it's a feeling that I'm never going to forget.
Just for you personally, what lessons did you learn, you know, just being on that international stage and being around players who obviously at the time had, like when it came to club football, they were playing club football and those players in the national team, as compared to our players who were actually still on the rise, as we only see now, you know, that the national leagues are coming up. But they had that experience already, so what did you learn from them at that time?
I think I really just gained a lot of experience, you know, being able to play on the biggest stage possible at an under 17 level. But I think what needs to be emphasized is really that individually, I don't think that South Africa is so far behind as what people think we are. I think it's the fact that we don't get to play with each other as often. You know, we don't get to have a 2-month training camp or a 3-month training camp, where we don't play with each other from a very young age like a lot of the countries do. And I think when it comes to an international stage like that, that's really what's important, is that they had a lot of team chemistry and a lot of way more practices together than what we were able to have.
Now, the good thing about it is that we have the SAFA National Women's League that is still, you know, in its infant stages, but in the long run, if, you know, everything comes together and we get sponsors that are backing it up, we can combat this problem of where players are not getting their time to, you know, to learn more of each other in the league aspect. What do you, just for the next 5 years, what are you hoping to see, you know, just locally? What differences that you would like to see? And also when it comes to national teams, what are you hoping to see us achieve?
It's amazing that SAFA has started the first ever professional league in SA, and I think it's a huge step for women's football. But for it to improve, I think we really need to look at the league and the type of facilities that players are getting to use and have to play on, and whether refs are arriving for matches or not. I think we just need to really try our best to make it as professional as possible. And once we do that, I think it's going to grow and become so much better than what it is, way more competitive. You know, a lot more money in the league, teams being able to really compete, and it's not just one team running away with it. And then in terms of national teams, with a couple more camps and further development with their players, maybe starting with the girls a bit younger, I think that we can really look at great things happening.
Do you think will help, you know, women's football rise in this country?
I think we need to look at consecutively qualifying for under 17 World Cups. We need to start making these under 20 World Cups, and then hopefully Banyana getting into every single World Cup and the Olympics that comes around, and winning CASAFA. It's things like that that'll really help women's football to grow, because we can show that we're not something to be dealt with lightly, that we can achieve at a national level.
Most definitely. And just lastly, as soon as lockdown is lifted and you're told that you can leave your house, what is the one thing that is on your list that you will certainly be doing?
As soon as lockdown's ended, the first thing I'm going to go do is train at a football field. I can't wait to get back on the pitch again.
We can only imagine. But, you know, just to round this all up and just to say we thank you, you know, so much for taking time out for G-Sport. And we want to wish you all the best, you know, for the future and continue rising.
No, thank you for the opportunity. Being able to speak out is a wonderful thing to do. And I really appreciate you guys listening. Thanks. I hope that I can do you and everybody in this country proud, and we can continue to achieve.